हेलो स्टूडेंट्स, माय सेल्फ मुरारी कुमार फ्रॉम आकाश ट्यूटोरियल्स, गौरव नगर, इस्लामपुर। इन दिस वीडियो वी विल स्टडी नेचर, साइज एंड पोजीशन ऑफ इमेज इज फॉर्म्ड व्हेन ऑब्जेक्ट इज प्लेस्ड इन फ्रंट ऑफ कॉन्वेक्स लेंस। इन आवर प्रीवियस क्लासेस वी हैड स्टडीड नेचर, साइज एंड पोजीशन ऑफ images formed by convex mirror when objects are placed in front of convex lens at infinity and between center of curvature or 2f. Today we will study nature, size and position of images formed when object is placed in front of convex lens at 2f, between 2f and f, at f and f and o, that is optic center of the lens. So now, as earlier we had studied that when object move towards the lens, image will move away from the lens and the image size of image will go on increasing. So now in this case, when object is placed at two f, so let us draw a ray diagram. This is a convex lens. We have various positions f, 2f and infinity. Our object is at 2f. So to plot a ray diagram, as I have said that one ray will move parallel to the principal axis, that will reflect through f2. These are f1 and 2f1. And another ray will move passing through O, and these all meet at 2f2. So we can say that when object is at 2f1, image will form at 2f2 and the image will be real, inverted and of same size. Let us again recall, when object is at 2f1, one ray will move parallel to the principal axis, which will pass through f2. Another ray will pass through optic center O. Both of them cross each other at the point 2f2, and there the image will form. The image will be real, inverted, form at 2f2 and of same size. Image will be of same size. As in our previous class, I have said that when object will move towards lens, image will go away from the lens and the size of image will go on increasing as the object move towards the lens. Now our fourth position, when the object is between 2f2 and f2, when object is situated between 2f1 and f1. Let us see what happens in this case. Suppose this is convex lens, the principal axis, optic center O, first point f1, next point 2f1, infinity, this side f2, 2f2 and infinity. Now, when object is situated between 2F1 and F1. In the same case, same way, one ray will be parallel to the principal axis, which will pass through F1, F2, which will pass through F2. And another ray will pass through optic center O, and both of the ray cross each other away from 2F2. Okay, let us recall again. One ray will parallel to the principal axis, which will pass through F2. Another ray will pass through optic center O. Both of them meet each other away from 2F2. And their image will form. So, in this case, image will be real and inverted. Image will be real and inverted. Image will be magnified. Image will be magnified, and image will form away from 2F2 or between 2F2 and infinity. Between 2F2 and infinity. This is our fourth case. Now let us discuss fifth case. When object is situated at 2F1. When object is situated at F1. What happens in this case? Let us see. When, let us draw again a convex lens. Okay. Now, positions F1. This is 2F1. Infinity. This is F2. This is 2F2. And infinity. In this case, our object is at F1. In the same case, same way, one ray will parallel to the principal axis, which will pass through F2. Another ray will pass through optic center O, and both of the ray will meet each other at infinity to form real and inverted image. So, in this case, we may say that when the object is at F1, image will form at infinity, and the image will be real, inverted and highly magnified. So, in this case, the image will be real and inverted. Image will be highly magnified. Image will form at infinity. This is our fifth case. Image will be real and inverted. Image will be highly magnified, and it will form at infinity. This is our fifth case, and the today's last case for convex lens. When the object is situated between F1 and O, that is optic center of the lens. Between F1 and O, that is optic center of the lens. Let us again draw a diagram. This is convex lens, optic center O. This is F1, 2F1, F2, 2F2. Again, here is the object between F1 and optic center O. Array will be parallel to the principal axis, which will pass through F2, and another ray will pass through O. Both of the ray imaginary will meet somewhere here. And the image will be virtual, erect and magnified. When object is placed between F1 and optic center O, the image will be virtual, erect and highly and magnified. So in this case, the image will be virtual and erect. Image will be magnified and image will form on same side. So we had discussed the nature, size and position of the images formed when object is placed at various position in front of convex lens. Now, as the important part of the optics is to find out nature, size and position of image placed in front of an optic instrument, that is mirror or lens, as well as application of mirror and lens formula. Now today we will study lens formula. There is no difference between the mirror formula and the lens formula. They are about alike. Whereas the mirror formula says the inverse of distance of object from mirror plus inverse of distance of image from mirror is equal to the inverse of focal length, right? Whereas in the case of lens, it says the inverse of the difference of inverse of distance of image from the lens and the distance of object from lens is equal to the inverse of focal length, that is 1 upon V minus U is equal to 1 upon F, where U is distance of image from the lens. U distance of object from the lens. F the focal length of the lens. And the same convention is as usual, which says U always negative, F positive for convex lens, negative for concave lens, V negative for real image, and positive for virtual image. Okay. Now let us do some numericals based on lens formula. And again we will check our answer, that whether our answer is correct or not, because no one will be in your examination hall to check or give a chance to solve the questions again. as in classroom a teacher might scold you or might we help you to correct your mistake, but examination hall no one will be there. So it became quite important that you recheck your answer. So first the question says that an object is placed at a distance of 35 centimeter from a convex lens of focal length 20 centimeter. Find the nature, size and position of the image formed. Now, given, what we have given? U is equal to minus 35 centimeter. U is always negative and U is the distance of object from the lens. And the distance from a object from the lens is 35 centimeter. F is 20 centimeter. Let us check whether F will positive or negative. So it says that convex lens, and for convex lens F will be positive, for concave lens F will be negative. Since here it is convex lens, so F will be positive, and we have to find out V is equal to what by applying Lense formula. What the Lense formula says? 1 upon V minus 1 upon U is equal to 1 upon F. That is 1 upon V minus 1 upon minus 35 is equal to 1 upon F. F means 20. That is 1 upon V minus minus plus 1 upon 35 is equal to 1 upon 20. That is 1 upon V, again sign change, variable aside, constant aside, variable to the left, constant to the right. 1 upon 20, inverse of plus is minus 1 upon 35. LCM of 20, 20, 2, 2 ja 4, 5 ja 20. 35, 7, 5 ja 35, 5 is common, so it will be 2. Multiply 2, multiply 7, multiply 5. 2 to the 4, 7 to the 28, 5 to the 140. So, LCM will be 140. 27 to the 140 minus 4. So, 1 upon V is equal to 7 minus 4, 3 upon 140. So, V is equal to 140 upon 3. Centimeter. That is 4, 3 are 12, 6, 3 are 18, 6, 6 centimeters. Let us recheck. F is 20 centimeter. 2F will be 40 centimeter. And U is 35 centimeter. Since object is between, which is between F and 2F. Between F and 2F. So, the image will form between 2F and infinity. As the object is between 2F, F and 2F, so image will be will form between 2F and infinity. That is, 2F must be greater than 40, that is 46.6 greater than 40, hence our answer is correct. Thanks for watching the video. Please like, share and subscribe my channel. Thank you.